know how maid of honor speeches go, but we'll try this out. I have so many memories of Erica, I don't even know where to start. I can't express how happy I am for you guys. It's easy to see how in love you are and how happy you make each other.
Matt, when you came to our house unexpectedly one fall day, we knew what you were about to say. It was a very proud moment for us when you asked for our blessing for Erica's hand in marriage.
You are lovely tonight. You, dear, will guide me into the morning light.
On the phone about nothing, and that you love doing things together like hiking, skiing, or playing with Kaya. Most of all, I think it's absolutely adorable that you cuddle at night before you go to sleep, even if you're mad at one another. You compliment each other so well, and I'm so happy you found one another to spend the rest of your lives with. I know you'll have a beautiful and happy marriage ahead of you.
You
Matthew, today I marry the love of my life, my best friend, my everything. I feel like the luckiest girl in the world. I wake up and go to sleep every night with the man of my dreams. And just when I think I couldn't love you more, I catch you staring at me with a smile on your face. Oh, you make me laugh and my heart melts and I fall in love all over again.
It's my everything. It's been 7+ years since we started this crazy trip. Every turn the road, good or bad, you've been right there by my side.
I can't wait to see what life has in store for us, and more importantly, I can't wait to experience it all with you.
I'm so excited to marry you and start a whole new road trip together. So thank you for being the best co-pilot, shotgun, navigator a guy could ask for.
I can't wait to see you in just a few hours and start the next chapter of our lives together, because our forever started 7 years ago when we were too young to know what an amazing journey we were just starting.
I love you with all my heart and then some. I'll see you soon. Don't worry, this day is already perfect because we're together. Your future husband, Matt.
We enjoy going hiking upstate in the Catskills, so there was a specific place that was very special to us. So I had went up earlier in the month with a friend of mine, and we carved it with a Dremel into a tree. And the plan was the next weekend to bring her back up there, but we had a freak 2-foot blizzard in October. I somehow convinced her that it would still be a good idea to go. So we went up there and I showed her one side of the tree where it said our initials and a heart.
Go look at it. I wouldn't have taken you up here unless it was important.
Tell that she thought it was cute, but she was kind of thinking to herself, she's probably gonna wait until next week or a month later. And that's when I tricked her to go around the tree, and that's when she saw it. The rest was history.
Hey, go into this side of the tree, take a picture. I think it says something else.
Are you for real? Oh my god, baby, are you serious?
I love you. Really?
I, Matthew.
And you, Erica.
Take you, Erica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I love and honor you.
I love and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Erica.
Take you, Matthew.
Take you, Matthew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In
good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love and honor you.
I will love and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I'd ask you to join with me that through our applause, we might offer our support to this newly married couple.
I'll share with you guys a quick story. It was the summer of 2007. Erica and Matt got into an epic fight, so epic that they broke up. The first time, only time they ever broke up. And that breakup lasted 3 days.
I stayed up at the sun. Thought of all of the people, places, and things I've loved. I stayed up just to see.
So for 3 days, what I witnessed was the saddest sight in a man I've ever seen in my entire life. I witnessed Matt not changing his clothes, not showering, sleeping on a dirty mattress that was on the floor of a dark abandoned frat house room. And all he lived off of was Entenmann's Devil's Food Cake.
If I lose myself tonight, it'll be by your side.
We all know, we heard Corinthians a million times, love is blind, love is kind, but to me, love was that. Love is eating devil's food cake. It's not showering, it's not shaving, it's losing your absolute mind for the thought of losing the one that you love most. That, I ask us all to raise our glasses, to never seeing those 3 days again, to health, wealth, and happiness forever. We love you guys.